Hello people. So today we are going to start our first lecture of Creo Parametric. So today we are going to draw this figure, as you can see over here. And if you install Creo Parametric for the first time, you will be seeing a few files like this. So you have to click on Creo Parametric. So it will take some time, out a few seconds. So this will be the home screen you will see. So first of all, you need to select a working directory. Here's a working directory. Mine is on desktop, YouTube, and then Creo. Okay. Then click OK button, and then click on New. Okay. So here you have to select part, because we are designing part over here, and subtype solid. So you can name it whichever you want, like I'm naming it as P1. So by default you can keep it, but I want to use some different template, so I'm using MNS. Okay, so let's start. So in file you can see there are a few things like new, open, save as, print, close, manage, prepare, send, manage session. In manage session you can erase current, and there are few other. You can change the working directory. In option you can modify your environment, model detail, entity detail section, catcher, and etc. We'll talk about that later. So there are few tabs: analysis, anodes, render, tool, view, flexible modeling, application. We'll talk about them later on. So for the initial tutorial, we're just going to focus on sketch and extrude. That's it. And a few other engineering modes like hole, round, chamfer, we'll see on later on this video. So here you can see that there are predefined three axes given to us, like front. This is the front, this is top, and this is right axis. If you want to draw any figure like this, like we have this one, so this would be our front view, this would be our top view, and this is the orthogonal figure we are having. So let's start with the top. So I'm choosing the top one. This is the top. Okay, you can directly choose from here also, front, back, bottom, right, top. So I have selected top, and now click on sketch. Now click on this button. Okay, before starting your sketch, you need to make sure to place center lines, so that your sketch should be aligned to the center, and it wouldn't create any problem in later on, like while doing assembly and other thing. So as I have selected this center line, and I've used it, and I need to skip from this command. So I need to either click on this arrow button, or I can just simply click on center button to skip from this command. Okay, now what do we have? We are having a rectangular piece with a hole and a circle over here, an arc. So let's draw it. You'll see the difference. If you are using center line, you will notice some arrow marks on the corners. These lines will show that your upper and lower part are symmetric. Upper part, lower part, your left and right are symmetric to each other. So simple, magnetic and out. Now you can change the dimension, like this one was 75, and enter, and this one is 30. Yeah, it's 30. This radius 15, so it's 30. So next step will be we need to draw a circle over here. This is a good thing about Creo. It takes it automatically takes the tangents and all these things, so you don't need to worry about that. Like these two points are automatic. So I'm taking another circle. So the center distance is 15. Okay, and its dia is 15. You can see over here 7.5 radius. So dia will be 15. Next thing, we are going to use this delete segment command. We don't need this line, these lines. So this is our top view. Let's confirm it. Yes, this is our top view. Almost. So now click on this green button. And now click on extrude. Here we are. So you can see it's 3D. And bottom of this extrude is attached to this axis, so I can move it to the center by this. So from here you can give the height of this, like its height is given as 30 over here. It's 30, so I'm giving it 30. You can manually adjust it like this, but to be accurate, okay, let's just do it like this. So now click on this green button and you'll have this 3D structure. You can hide those lines like this, but if you want to keep it, that would be easier for you for many purposes. So next, move on further. What we have to do next? Okay, next thing, we need to extrude this part. We have this circle and we need to extrude this part. And how much is this? This is 16. Okay, so this is 75 and this is 18 and this is 15. So 75 minus 18 minus 15 will get 42. So let's do it. We need to work on this plane, so click on this plane and click on extrude. Okay, next thing you need to do is click on this reference button so that you can easily you can easily capture these axes. It wouldn't be difficult. That would be enough. Okay, now close. So these lines will help you to pinpoint to make exact exact point, exact dimension. Next thing, we need to draw a rectangle. Look, that what I was telling you. You need to take care. So, click on OK. Okay, now we have to remove this. So how much depth we need? It's 9. So it's 21, and we need to remove it, so we have to click on this button, remove material, and here it is. Click on OK. So here it's done. Now we can see front view, top view, Now, next thing we need to do is to make this chamfer, and these chamfers are in 99. Okay, so let's do it. Here is the chamfer command. So after clicking on chamfer, you need to select the corner. Let's it's 9 over here. Okay, that is D into D. Now click on OK button. So here we are. Now the next thing is we need to draw this slant. For that you need to click on this button, this axis, and click on extrude. So again, click on reference, select view, click OK. Now this time I'm taking a line. Enter button. Okay, so now you can see that that's why I'm telling you to keep the drawing almost if you're using a single axis, and try to keep a synchronized try to move in a synchronized way. It's my you can call it habit or my ease to keep everything on a center axis. That would be easier for me to assemble on any other thing. So next thing we are going to do is giving the dimension, that is 7. Click on green button, and here we can see that it's done. Now if you want, you can deselect it. Is front view, here is top view, here is standard orientation. Okay, and there are different things you can do, like no hidden lines from this, shaded edges, hidden lines, yes. Okay, so wireframe and simple reflective. Okay, now click on save button. Click OK. Before that, if you want some further modification, like if you want to give appearance to it, you can change its appearance. From here you can choose like color. Okay, and I'd want this to be red in color. So okay, and outside I want this to be yellow in color, and the other portion also I can select it and control, click OK. Likewise I can give green color to all other parts by pressing on control. I can select the whole like that and click on OK. And some blue if you want. this is how our part look like. So Control D to its orientation. So you can do other things like render and perspective view. Okay, now click on save button and okay button.